Here we go again with more World Cup coverage. And we have Poik versus Sijumas. And I'm kind of familiar with this team that Poik has, or at least with a team that is similar to this. Because I've seen NGNP post like a team like this. And I think the Tita was Chopperberry with... Was it Chopperberry with Ice Beam? It's Psychic Spam. It's basically... It's kind of slow, the team. I don't know if would it be Banta? Nah, I could actually see Banta on this team, because the other version of this team I had, I think it didn't have a Land Royce. Like, he has a few options. A Megazem, probably. Like, for a second I was thinking about potentially Mega Tita, but I think he's Mega Zen. So I think the Tita is either Chopper or Bandit. But I'm kind of leaning towards Bandit. And the Lando is going to be Z-move, I assume. So it's either SD Lando with two attacks and rocks. Or he has rocks on Pharaoh and the Lando could be Double Dance. Something along those lines. Yeah, Lele is another potential Z-move one, but I think it's more likely that the Z-move is on Landorus. And yeah, Sijumas bringing some bulky offense. Actually not sure which Charizard that is. He leads up with Greninja. Looking at his team, I assume it's gonna be Scarf Greninja. Yeah, I assume it's gonna be Scarf Greninja. Scarf Protein. So if Poik has Toxic or T-Spikes, like one of the two, he's probably gonna click that. I mean, he can also just click Scald, fishing for a burn on the Ferrothorn slash Zapdos. I don't think that Sijumas would... Like, I think he would rather U-turn out or hard switch out into Ferrothorn, because if he goes Zapdos on a Toxic, it would be bad for him. But yeah, he U-turns out, which kind of confirms that it's Scarf Gren, like that's the set that runs U-turn most of the time, basically, on Protein. And even on Ash, like, I mean, Ash Greninja obviously isn't Scarf, that's a different story, let's not talk about that now. This is obviously Scarf Protein Gren, like, there's not much to discuss. Yeah, it does get up a T-Spike, definitely solid. Zapdos can defog without getting poisoned, obviously, because it's in the air. I see a lot of like packs carry Toxic over Toxic Spikes to be able to status Zapdos. And that's like another one that Toxic Packs appreciates, clicking Toxic on over T-Spikes, but it can't think about it. The moment was... Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's Toxic on Toxic Specs is nice in general, because poison types have 100% accurate Toxic, they can't miss it. Oh yeah, we have Tapu Lele on both sides, this is interesting. I assume this is gonna be... I could see this being a Z-move Tapu Lele and a choice Bandit Zygarde on Sijumas' team. But he could also be Dragon Dance, Z-move Zygarde, and a different item on Lele, like Twisted Spoon or Shed Shell. Yeah, you already showed Scarf Gren, so this is definitely... Yeah, this is some sort of wall-breaking Lele, basically. Like, either Z-move wall breaking or some damage boosting item. Because, yeah, I know Poik can basically bring everything. But it's not that often that he's... Like, he's not gonna bring Stall that often, so I don't think this would be Shed Shell. Well, I haven't really seen Poik use Dugtrio either. But I haven't followed all his tour games, but I've followed like a good amount of his tour games. At least in OU. Yeah, UU Premier League I haven't followed that much. So Poeg is taking his time here. I could see this being Z Focus Blast. Because that would help him get rid of. I mean, it helps him to get rid of Tita. Like, if Tita thinks. Okay, that doesn't do much. Like, if Tita thinks this is, like, choice Lily and comes in on a Psy Shock, then you can Alert Pummeling that away. And what else does Alert Pummeling help versus? It helps versus Heatran, yeah. Yeah, and getting rid of Heatran could help out a potential. Yeah, it could help with your Charizard. If your Charizard is potential Zard Y without Focus Blast or without Earthquake. I mean, even if it has Focus Blast, you still have to rely on Focus Blast. As he did pivot into Tapu Lele, they're scouting for the All Out Pummeling. Because it is 4 times resisted, so that play makes sense. Yeah, I think it could be All Out Pummeling to get rid of basically Tyranitar Heatran for his Zard. Yeah, Zard Y, and like the Zard Y could be HP Ice, Fire Blast, Tailwind, Solar Beam. I've seen Tailwind around, but I kind of like Roost better over Tailwind, to be honest. Like when I use Zard Y myself. And yeah, ever since Mega Medicham came out, unless I have a Mew in my team to switch into Medicham, I always run max speed on my Zards. Yeah, that Fire Blast doesn't do anything, I assume that's timid. This Pex is gonna have some speed def. Yeah, I recorded Poeg's first World Cup game the other day. Was it 2 days ago? I think it was 2 days ago with the Gypsy King. And Sijumas, I think I recorded his game. If I recall correctly, it was Destiny Device from Team Brazil. He does go for Focus Blast there. Not really sure why. Predicting some sort of double. Did he have a reason to double? Maybe he predicted. Yeah, I think he predicted the Tyranitar. So, let me explain this to you. I think he predicted Poeg to go into Tyranitar, predicting Poeg to predict the Zapdos to come out. And if he's Bantar and he plays it correct, he can go for Pursuit. Or Crunch, he could have just gone for Crunch on the Zapdos and getting really good damage on Sijuma's team here. So I kind of understand the play, but I probably still wouldn't have made it. But yeah, this is another example, exactly. I was talking about Toxic Toxapex earlier. Toxapex walled Zard Y, right? But it can't do anything back. You guys see Scald only has 14%. So like, they're basically sitting in there and they can't really hurt each other. So if Toxapex had Toxic, it would beat the Zard Y easily 1-on-1. But I mean, Sijuma Zard is gonna be forced out, especially when the sun ends eventually. But you can see that Scald only did 14%, so like, Zard can even stall that out with Roost and stuff. And this Spadef drop is also really annoying for Poeg. But he does recover, like, he just was just recover spamming, and even with the Spadef drop, the sun might have ran out before he was able to kill this. Before he would have been able to kill this Toxapex with enough solar beams. Like before he could have fired off enough solar beams, basically. But you guys go hard into Tita. And I'm clicking Crunchy all the time. Because Stone Edge can miss one. Stone Edge can miss. B. Stone Edge would let in the Zygarde there. Yeah, I'm clicking Crunch every time. Agree with that play. So if that's a Fist Def, a Ferrothorn, like more Fist Def orientated, I think that's Banta, yeah. I want to Kalk to confirm though. Yeah, Crunch has 42 to 49. And it's 47 exactly, that's banded. That was the Impish 88 Defense Ferrothorn, which is a pretty common set. Like, some run more Spadef if it's the main Greninja check of some teams, like Ferro runs a lot of Spadef. Like, I've seen a spread with like 42 in defense and the rest in Spadef, something like that. But yes, Ijumas is gonna click Power Whip here, I assume, because his Tita is just a big threat. I don't think Poik is gonna stay in. I mean, he can click Jarrowball too, obviously. I think Poik is just gonna go into his Toxapex or his Landorus. Oh, he goes on his own Ferrothorn, wow. Okay, Ijumas throws up the rocks, knowing that Tita most likely won't stay in. That's a cool play. And yeah, I assume he's gonna get up a layer of spike. Oh, he has rocks on this, wow. So this means he doesn't have rocks on his Landorus. I guess he could be Scarf Landorus. I didn't even think about speed control on Poik's team so far. Nah, he's either Scarf Lele or Scarf Landorus. I'm still leaning more towards Scarf Lele plus Zeme of Landorus, yeah. And also, like, his team, yeah, it still kind of loses to Volcarona plus Dugtrio because that would get rid of, oh my god, the Zard is getting Spadef drops and crits, but their packs can still recover unless it gets crit again here. I mean, Volcarona plus Duggy is like, it's not that easy to build with, but it's like super hard to prepare for. So like, like, if you look at a lot of teams, it's hard to not find a team that like somehow loses to Volcarona plus Duggy. Because like one of few, like the few checks that Volcarona has, or like the few good checks that Volcarona has, that combination with Dugtrio, like, it's pretty deadly. And it frees up another move slot in Volcarona, like, you don't have to run HP ground, you can run HP ice, or like Bug Buzz if you wanna for Latias. Basically frees up a slot. But yeah, he did switch out into Lele on the recover. Yeah, Poik wants this Toxapex, as it pretty much completely walls the Greninja. It helps him versus the Zardwire, obviously. So I don't think he's gonna be staying in here and let his Toxapex get weakened. This is kinda a tough turn, to be honest. If Ijumas gets the call correctly and clicks Focus Blast, this is gonna be bad. He just goes for Psyshock. And last time he switched out after Psyshocking, right? I don't think he's choice, like, I think he's gonna reveal the Focus Blast eventually. I can see Poik switching. If he's Jolly Landorus and Z-move, I could see him into Landorus. Going Landorus here, scouting. Yeah, either Lilo or Landorus scouting for the fighting move. There is the all-out pummeling Poik with ingenious plays. I blunder the chat, is Poik the best ever? Like, I knew, like, Ijumas didn't reveal it the first time, he was like saving it up. But like, Poik, you can't just do that with Poik. Poik is too good. Ingenious scouting maneuvers. I assume Poik's Lele Scarf gets a special attack drop, which is a bit annoying. So Dirt said in the chat, you should have just fought Tinium to Toxapex. Yeah, that is true. I can kind of get behind that because there was no way the Toxapex was staying in. He needs it for the Zard. Yeah, Poik's one team actually was fired. I agree. We will see if one of the Ferro's ones has knockoff. It's gonna be nice. It can definitely. Also, if one of the Ferrothorns, like, the Ferrothorn that has knockoff obviously beats the other Ferrothorn. Also, if one, they both have knockoff, okay, that answers my question. So, both Ferrothorns are getting really low now, they don't have, both players don't have Wish Path or anything. I don't think Tapu Lele gets Healing Wish, yeah, I don't think, yeah, it doesn't. So, these Ferrothorns are gonna be at low range, which means Lele is gonna become a threat to Jima's Lele, but the thing is, it's at 22 after rocks. So it's not I don't think it's gonna be like winning. It might get one kill. I mean, he obviously gets outspent by Zam. What was Lin's base speed again? Was it 95? I always forget. Goes on Zapdos, I assume he's gonna defog here or discharge. And yeah, I assume he's gonna sack off his Ferrothorn here maybe. I can also see him going for Roost to scout what a Tita goes for. But if Tita just goes for Crunch, it doesn't really help you. Why did I do Tapu Bulu? I meant to data Tapu later, good lord. Do not record when you're tired. Trust. JK, this is fun. Tapu Lele. Yeah, it's 95 speed. Wow, I actually remember that correct. He goes for... Yeah, so CGMS predicted the Stone Edge went hard Zygarde. Zygarde still eats it up decently well. Like, it just has great natural bulk. So he has shown all out pummeling on the Lele. So I assume the Zygarde is banded. And this Landorus is gonna take like 40 of... Oh wow, his defensive Landorus. Oh, this might be the set that NGMP likes to run a lot. Which is... Protect Toxic Landorus with... Earthquake. Like, he has run it with Stealth Rock, but this team has already shown that a Stealth Rock user. So it has U-turn, okay. I assume U-turn, Earthquake, Protect, Hidden Power, Ice maybe? Because Leftovers Protect Land was like kinda common at the moment, and it's a nice way to check Zygarde, because with Leftovers and Protect you can like nicely get your health back. Come in like, eventually come in, or potentially come in one more time on Morwell than you could otherwise. Thousand Arrows also doesn't make contact, so you don't really gain anything from running Rocky Helmet on Landorus when like the one of the most common ones Zygarde doesn't make contact. Like, you don't gain anything from running Helmet, you obviously just want Leftovers in that scenario if it's Landorus versus Zygarde. But yeah, Tita, I think that's a Scarf Tita, was it? No, never mind, what the fuck am I saying? I did Kalk earlier with Ferrothorn, it was banded, right? Yeah, I was just tripping, what the fuck. Like, the thing is, why would you go into Tyranitar here if you're not Scarf? Because you died of Focus Blast. So yeah, he just made it to go back into Toxapex. It's like I was just about to say, if Poik stays in here, what the fuck? Is he really willing to sack that? But yeah, he just goes into Pex and... Shijuma's making a really nice play in the Tapu Lele. And yeah, he has to predict here correct between Toxapex staying in. I could see the Poik just sacking off the Ferrothorn. Yeah, I can see Shijuma's just playing it safe and clicking Psyshock. Like, even if the Tita comes out, you still get a chance to like, Focus Blast in the next turn anyway. You still have to hit it, but... But yeah, Poik's team is just a little bit more healthy overall. This Regenerator Pex is coming in clutch. Like, Lele is the main way of breaking this. And the other one is the Zygarde. If those two go down, or like... if the Zygarde gets like burned, this is completely over. Like, there's a Zapdos, yeah, but... Like, Zapdos doesn't even do that much to Toxapex. And he still has a Tita for the Zapdos in the back. His Tita still has a respectable amount of health. He goes hard into Zem. Really not wanting to let his Pex take any damage. I thought he might sack the Pharaoh instead, like I said earlier. And yeah, like, Zem is gonna either click Shadow Ball or... Yeah, I assume Shadow Ball or Dazzling Gleam. Tough time for Shijuma's. Like, what is he gonna sack? Bruce Harden is a Zygarde, so he can that can live a Shadow Ball, especially when he stays in regular form. So he stayed in regular form because he has Magic Guard, which avoids the Sandstorm damage here. So he threatens him out with the Extreme Speed. And Poik has a Landorus, so I can see CGMOS predicting the Landorus and going for a Toxic or for a 1000 Arrows, but he goes into Greninja predicting it. And this did not work out. I mean, yeah, this works out fine for Poik. Yeah, CGMOS eats it up and can click U-turn here, but Poik still didn't lose much from doing this. Like, you can just go into this Toxapex here as the Greninja will U-turn and then it will bring in the... will U-turn and that will bring in the Tapu Lele or the Zygarde. I assume the Tapu Lele is going to be coming out. I'll just gotta check real quick if that ICT game that I uploaded is in private or in public. Oh yeah, I have the Grease game that I have to re-narrate. Okay, it's in private, nice, because I didn't make a thumbnail yet. I don't want to upload videos without thumbnail. When Finch doesn't know his player is about to play. I mean, he's either go into Zygarde a little, like I said. Okay, he goes into Zygarde. And if he has Toxic, I think he's gonna click it on the... to weaken the Landorus. And let's just go for 1000 Arrows. I mean, yeah, he can weaken this, but if it has Protect, it's still getting health back anyway. Yeah, I don't really like this about some of the tournaments, that like there's like one or two, like a few days with like where like little or no games happen, and then like towards the weekend there's like so many games at one day that I can't, that I have trouble following. He does just go for U-turn, so his Landorus is getting low now, it can't really switch into Zygarde anymore, but I can understand that he just wants the momentum. So, Poik wants his hazards up for the Zard, his rocks. I can see Poik going for Leech Seed though, predicting the Zapdos switch, because CGMOS wants to get rid of the hazards immediately. So I could see him going to Zapdos here, and yeah, like I said, Leech Seed would be a nice play to get some health back. Because if you get out of rocks, he's just going to defog them away and you're not going to get any health back, because your leftovers got knocked off, so why not just go for Leech Seed, predict the switch. I don't think CGMOS is gonna stay in here with his Pharaoh. Oh wow, his timer's running kinda low. Don't time out, dude. But yeah, he goes on the Zapdos. Poik makes the safe play, just throws up the rocks. I really thought Leech Seed would have been fine there, but rocks works too because it gives you T-Tar free switch in. And yeah, he just clicks Crunch again. Like, he either has to let his Greninja take a huge hit. Oh, Greninja might even die with Sandstorm or get brought really, really low. So that's not the play going hard. And he's either taking the Zygarde or the Ferrothorn here. Or he's going for Discharge Bearer, but yeah, he sacks off his Ferrothorn to the Crunch, gets some more chip damage with Iron Barbs on the Tyranitar. Okay, brings out his own Zygarde and he's gonna click 1000 Arrows and 2-hit KO the Landorus, I assume. Oh, so I has Protect, but it doesn't matter at this point. Like, he's still in 2-hit KO range. I don't think it's worth a poke to switch into anything else. Because Alakazam is still really fast, so it's worth to keep Alakazam's speed over, like, keeping this Landorus. Yeah, I don't see him sacking anything other than Lando. Because for double protect, respectable. Like, I mean, I obviously understand why not go for it. If you get it, you can potentially lift the next hit. So I think you can go Alakazam here. Okay, goes Lily. That sets up the psychic terrain for Alakazam, that makes sense too. I mean, and for Lily itself, obviously. So he clicks Moonblast. Gives the Zard a switch in, but that's fine. Because he has a Toxaplex to wall Zard, so yeah, I would probably just click Moonblast here. I think Sigimas has to play this aggressive to come back, which means you would have to break tier correct between Moonblast and Psychic move. So if he breaks the Moonblast, he goes into Zard. And then Poik has a Toxapex to switch in, so he has to double out into Zygarde on the Toxapex. And then he also has to avoid a Scald Burn because he can't Oko Toxapex. This is a fat man, you know? But he definitely has to make some sort of plays here. Damn, Toxapex showing why it's so annoying in this game. I mean, it's not even out at the moment. Yeah, Lily is really nice. Like, if you have something like Mantine or Toxapex in the back that can wall Zard, is that why in most variants? Oh my lord, stop this boy. Like I said, he had to make risky plays. I didn't think he would have gone Greninja, but he got this play correct. And he gets a U-turn here on Toxapex, and then he gets, yeah, he gets a U-turn here, gets to bring in his Zygarde on a Toxapex. So it's kind of the same scenario that I was talking about, going Zard on a Moonblast, doubling into Zygarde. Or, yeah, going Greninja on a Psychic and then U-turning into Zygarde. Kind of the same scenario, right? I mean, you can also U-turn into Zapdos and, like, try to discharge Pear or something, but I think Zygarde is more threatening. If Zygarde, I don't think Zygarde dies from the range, it's added to a Scald, because Toxapex is pissed weak, so he just has to avoid a Scald Burn. Yeah, U-turns out, I think Zygarde comes in. I mean, it's between Zygarde and Lily again. Maybe he's calculating if Zygarde could live a Scald. But yeah, just make the Zygarde play. You guys can hear him tired. Almost had to yawn really bad there. Why is he talking Spanish in the chat? I don't understand anything, dude. But Tierras is gonna 2-hit kill this Ferrothorn. Yeah, Ferrothorn wasn't really needed at this point. I agree with sacking that. Like, Pex is obviously still necessary. You don't wanna let that take a huge 1000 arrows and potentially, like, even get Oko'd by a crit. I think a crit could Oko Toxapex, right? A Bandit Tierras crit. I'm not calculating, I'm too tired. When is Zygarde getting banned? I don't think it's getting banned. I mean, yeah, I know that Zygarde is annoying, but there's like a lot of mons with it. Like, if they have the correct moves that they can run through a team, or if they like get the set of opportunity, like, let's say Shift Gear Majuna as an example, Greninja as an example, was like with the correct coverage, was like slower teams Greninja run through. But yeah, you can play around stuff like that. I don't think the meta is that bad at the moment. Like, some people make it like talk about it as if it's really bad. It's definitely not the best, but like Zemuth, I'm kind of tossed up. I kind of hate Zemuth and I kind of like Zemuth at the same time. Like sometimes they're just broken. This is a nice play, by the way, going Alakazam. And yeah, another time Zemuth just don't do much, and other times they're just putting so much work. But most of the times they do like a lot of work. But yeah, he goes into the Zam here. He can just click Psychic or Dazzling Gleam if he has it. Like, Psychic Terrain boosted Psychic is scary. And CGMAS has shown that he went into Greninja before, so he was potentially assuming that Poek would not go for Psychic. That's why CGMAS didn't make the grand play again. Gets the U-turn out. It's gonna go into Zygarde here. It's gonna click 1000 arrows. I don't see another play, so make your move already, dude. I don't wanna wait all day, please play. It's already 31 minutes, dude. Wow, ABI said this is over, CGMAS is sick. Did you really bring it back? I mean, that play hard into Greninja the Psychic, that was definitely one of the turns that brought him some momentum back, let's put it that way. I'm not sure if he wins yet, but Poek will have to take something to the Zygarde here. I mean, not necessarily, because you know, Toxapex can get the burn. We will call quick. Toxapex versus Zygarde, are your choice banned? 1000 arrows does 73 to 87, so it doesn't kill. Versus this, if it's this spread, then 192 bold one. And score does 15 to 18, so he needs a. Yeah, knowing Showdown runs down to the Zygarde. Oh, it's at 17, I thought it was at 19, never mind. So score has a chance to kill, like. It's the roll, yeah. I think the roll is slightly in Poek's favor. But he's gonna get the T arrows here, and this. If he doesn't, oh my god, that kills. So this Toxapex is really spidef. I know that it was a little bit more spidef than the one in the Kalk, but I still think this was a roll potentially. Wow, that's crazy. Zygarde at 30% getting 3 kills. CGMAS playing like a complete overlord, like. I mean, I didn't really sound excited saying that. I should have sounded more excited, but trust me, I'm tired. I've probably said that a few times by now. But like, this was actually not a bad game. Like, it was a little bit stale and it took its time, but like, CGMAS didn't give up after Poek made a nice play. Like switching out on the all-out pummeling. Yeah, and it's still kind of iffy for Poek. I think he's gonna. Yeah, the thing is, if you click Psychic, the Greninja gets a free switch in. So there's always mind games. But at this point, CGMAS is up 4-3, so he basically, if he plays this well, I think he has. If he goes into that, I think Poek will go for Psychic, exactly. He will go for Psychic again, because last time he went into Greninja, he's not going to Greninja again. Oh my lord, they're both playing this so well. I mean, maybe not every turn was perfect, but like a lot of this game was like just amazing to watch. Nick said he should have sacked Zapdos. Yeah, he's gonna click U-turn here and get a kill with his Greninja. I don't think it matters too much. Like, Leek says Zapdos takes the play, but doesn't Scarf Greninja just win with U-turn? Like, what does Poek have to prevent Scarf Grin from sweeping now? Maybe Tita lives one and if it's HP invested? But he will get the chip damage that he needs on Tita if that's the case. I'm pretty sure that CGMAS has this now. Wow. One of the games that I thought would have been over a while ago in Poek's favor, but Bennett Zygaard and aggressive playing from CG must part bringing him back into this. Yeah, Zygaard is definitely getting something for this one, like, no doubt in my mind, obviously. Sex of the Alakazam to this U-turn. I mean, how much would Tyranitar do take from U-turn? I wanna know if it's already in range. It also depends, obviously, on the Greninja set. Does he not have Choice Scarf Greninja? We have his Battle Spot Choice Scarf one, so I have to put this to level 100. So he still didn't make his play. This is Psychic Terrain up, by the way, I gotta check that. He goes into Zapdos, gets some extra leftovers. And I assume he's gonna be forced to go into Tyranitar here. I mean, I can put a max attack in the Kulk. It would be able to figure out probably the spread from the Greninja. If it's more physical or my special attack. And yeah, U-turn doesn't kill yet, even if it's max attack naive. Okay, nice. That's just what I wanted to know. So he got the necessary damage off. And now the Tyranitar is in range from U-turn if the Greninja is max attack. So it seems the Greninja might not be max attack, or he doesn't want to risk the Tita having some weird spread that is bulky. He just goes into Bennett Zygaard instead, which is the better play. Scarflator picks off the Zygaard. And Scarf Greninja will win the game for CGMAT with a U-turn here. Really well played, close game. This was one of my highlights of the day so far. Even though, like I said like a few minutes ago, it was a little bit long and like might have been boring for some people at one point, but definitely worth the watch. And there's already another game, so thank you guys for watching. I'll be back with more. Peace out. We have Porygon vs. Wailuza coming up next. So yeah, Porygon was on Team Spain, and Cijumas picks up the win for Team France. He's 2-0 now, showing that he's no joke, and he's in the tour scene. He's showing off, and yeah, peace out, guys.